Good morning, dear students. A hearty welcome to all of you. Today is the first class, and therefore we are going to start with our first chapter in science, which is reproduction in plants. I have divided this chapter into short segments, and we will study these segments accordingly. The things which we are going to study in the first segment of this chapter are reproduction, types of reproduction, parts of a plant, structure of a seed, and types of seed. To sustain our life, nature has given us many beautiful and precious gifts. Plants are one such gift of Mother Nature. Plants are our green friends, and they are useful to us in many ways. Can you tell me how they are useful to us? Yes, they provide us food, which we eat. They provide us oxygen to breathe. There are certain plants which provide us medicines. Wood for furniture, fiber for cloth, and many more things. Can we imagine our life without plants? But to fulfill our various requirements, we often cut down plants and trees. But the plants again increase in number in a certain period of time. Have you ever thought of why they increase in number again? They can do this because they are living beings. And they have a special quality or a speciality which is called reproduction. They have the ability of producing, or we can say reproducing, the young ones of their own kind. And this process is called reproduction. If we split the word reproduction, we'll find re and production. Re means again, and production means to produce. So the definition becomes the ability of living beings to produce their own kind so that they can increase in number is called reproduction. The ability to produce same kind is called reproduction. Now this reproduction can be of two types. Either it can be from seeds, or it can be through different parts of plant. And to understand this, we need to understand or see the different parts of a plant. So here you can see the diagram of a plant. Here its different parts are shown, and you all know that a plant has two main parts. The one which is above the soil and the other which is under the soil. The part which is under the soil is the root, and the part which is above the soil consists the shoot system. Now this shoot system has different parts. As you can see from the picture, there are leaves, there are branches, there are flowers and buds. So the plant is mainly categorized into two parts if we talk about reproduction. It means they can reproduce through two basic parts. The first part is the vegetative part. As you can see in the chart, in this classification also, the vegetative part consists of stem, then leaves, and then roots. These three are the vegetative parts of a plant. While the reproductive part of a plant is their flowers. In the previous picture, I have shown you that plants have two main reproductive parts, the flowers and the vegetative parts. we'll talk about the reproduction through flies. There are many plants which produce flowers, and from these flowers they produce, or these flowers grow into fruits. These fruits carry seeds in them. Can you name any fruit? Yes. You can imagine any fruit and the seeds present in that fruit. In these seeds, there is a structure which is called embryo, and this embryo is responsible for the production of a new plant. So here we'll talk about the structure of a seed, which is very important since it is producing the new generation of a plant. So in the structure of a seed, if we talk about from the outer side, we can see a hard covering which is called seed coat. Now this seed coat is the outer covering, and hence it protects the seed from the outer harsh environment. Next, you can see two fleshy structures. These fleshy structures, which are attached together, these are called cotyledons. Why they are fleshy? They are fleshy because they are having the stored food in them. So inside the seed coat, two parts are present which are called cotyledons, and they are also known as seed leaves. They contain food for the growing baby, and therefore they become fleshy. A small greenish leaf like structure is present between the seed leaves, and this small greenish seed leaf-like structure is called the embryo or the baby plant. Now this embryo is further divided into plumule and radicle, which are responsible for the formation of shoot and root of the plant. In the previous diagram, I have shown you that there is a leaf-like structure which is called embryo, and it is getting developed into a new plant. Now this embryo is inside the seed. So from where it is getting its nutrition? It is getting its nutrition from the fleshy cotyledons. These fleshy cotyledons have stored food in them. It is providing nutrition to the developing embryo so that it can develop into a well-developed new plant with proper root and shoot system. But these cotyledons can be either two in number or one in number. And on the basis of their numbers in the seed, the seeds can be divided into two types, dicot seed and monocot seed. Dicot seed. As the name indicates, di, which means two, and cot refers to cotyledons. So the seeds which have two cotyledons or two seed leaves, they are called dicot seed. And monocot seed, mono means single, and cot refers to cotyledon. So the seeds which are having single cotyledon are called monocot seed. In the next video, I'll show you the dicot seed and the monocot seed, and we'll discuss about seed germination and the factors which are affecting or which affect the process of seed germination.